QShift is a new way to apply live offsets within QuickShow and beyond for the 5.5 release. This tool utilizes the live control tab effects to create an oscillating style AB effect with them, and applies these effects to different zones with different accelerations and time delays. This can then be interfaced live utilizing a two-dimension pad style interface where you can apply those effects percentages over the y-axis and change the delay amount and direction with the x-axis. QShift is designed as a live effect tool and not a timeline tool. It can only be used in the grid area of Beyond and related outputs. On the Live Control tab, next to the Global, Queue, and Zone options, you will now see an A and a B. These are your new start and finish selections for your QShift effects. Let's start by selecting the first pad and highlighting it. By default, this is a size-based effect. Now let's click on the A button to see the start setting. Here you can see that the size is set to 0 at the start position. Now if we click on the B button, you'll see the size is set to max. When we apply the quick shift effect, you'll see this zoom from 0 to full happen along the zones. When switching between pads, the A and B buttons on the live control will adjust to be the setting of the current pad. This is how you can both build and live adjust your QShift effects. Because of many code and development reasons, the QShift implementation of offset effects is significantly more layerable than offset effects with the main effects engine. This is a very light-duty way to create basic offset effects without the CPU needs of the full effects engine. Also of note, this system is separate from the main effects engine, so they can be used with each other and offset separately. Now let's look at how the offset will be applied and changed utilizing the QShift pad properties. Select the pad you'd like to work on, then click on the Pad Properties button to open up the Pad Properties window. On the General tab, you'll have a few options, including name and color of the pad. And then you can select if you'd like a 2D pad or just a 1D pad. 2D pad allows for offsets in both directions, while 1D will just give you access to the effect amount on the pad. You can also select the Move action to mouse down position. This will instantly move the offset effect to the position on the pad where you clicked. This can be useful for touchscreens or for quick changes. You can disable to require you to select the cursor for moving. This may be more reliable for consistent changes. Under the Shifts and Wave tab is where you find most of the real offset properties will be. First option is for tempo. This is where you will select the total beats of the flow. In this case, 4 over 4 is a good option for 1 beat per loop, and 4 over 1 is a good option for 1 bar. This is measured in bars here due to how timing will work within the delay percentage. All QShift effects utilize the global BPM. The next option you have between period shift item in percentage or period shift per selection in percentage. Period shift per item will be the percentage delay between each selected zone. In this case, 25% would mean the offset will happen over 4 selected zones, and then that would be the offset loop. Period shift per selection means that over all the selected zones, the loop will happen this percentage amount of time. If you only want to see all of your lasers visibly doing half the effect at once, you would choose 50%. If you wanted all of your lasers to have the loop twice within your visibility, it would be 200% and so on. Next, you will select the DIV and MOD values. DIV is basically a groups selection. With this set to 0 or 1, every single zone will be seen as an individual item to get time offsets. If the value is 2, every 2 zones will be seen as a single offset item for that effect. 4 before, and so on. MOD value is a total steps selection. This means that it'll divide your selections as evenly as possible to achieve whatever number of steps mod value is. If you have 20 lasers and you want pairs, make the value 10. If you wanted quads, make it 5. Below all the selectable values, you'll have access to the waveform for the effect you set. Here you'll find all your expected and common waveform types, as well as a few new ones added for QShift. There are many to choose from. You can also choose to invert the waveform with this checkbox, or change the waveform width to add space between your effects, so not all lasers are being affected at all times. Finally, we have the Destinations tab. QShift effects, when there are no selected destinations here, will take the selection done by anything else. This could mean manual selection or default selections on the queue itself. However, if you'd like to create specific selection order or only affect some zones while leaving others alone, considering a graphic zone within mostly beam zones, for instance, you can set zones to manually be selected for the effect. you should utilize selections here to apply Q-shift offset effects in a symmetrical direction. Consider this zone setup with 6 lasers up and 6 down. Let's select outside in. 1, 6, and 7, 12 is our outside zones, which should be set first. Continue from there. In the end, this destination list should look something like this. Now we go back to the shifts and waves, we change our mod value back to 0 and our div value to either 2 or 4. This will create symmetrical groupings to create inside out or outside in effects. Selection order matters for these effects. With the destination being selectable per Q-shift pad, you can have some symmetrical, some straight, or whatever you'd like. Q-shift pads are best used with a touchscreen or mouse, but can be mappable to MIDI or controllable via scripts. You can find the parameters within the object tree. Action is the effect amount, width is the delay amount, and phase direction is which direction it's going. Thanks for watching this quick hints video on the new Q-shift Quick Tooltab effects engine. If you still have questions or need help, feel free to email support@pangolin.com or check the wiki at wiki.pangolin.com for a full written document on the Q-shift effects.